Ladies and gentlemen, it's time. It's the grand final here of the Call of Duty tournament at ACL Brisbane 2015, brought to you by our sponsors Astro, BenQ, and HyperX. I'm in Maniac. I'm joined by the captains here of our grand final teams, Plantronics, Mindfreak. We have Buzzo, and to my right, we have from Trident Damage. Now, I'll start with you, Buzzo. Winning the winners bracket final, getting your place, cementing it here in the grand final. You guys have been calm, cool, and collected all day, and you're just exuding confidence right now. Tell me, how are you feeling?
Oh, feeling great. You know, we beat him online, and we'll beat him at LAN.
Well, that I said exuding confidence. I wasn't lying. Buzzo Karen here with the thumbs up as well. Now, this is a continuation series for those of you who may not know. So in the winner's bracket, it was Trident that were taken down by Mindfreak. It was a 3-0 fashion. Tell me, Damage, does that affect the headspace of your team and does it affect your confidence at all?
No, definitely not. We're still very confident. Every map's, you know, got different strategies to it and different play styles. So, honestly, I think, you know, we got plenty more maps to play and we got plenty more maps to win, so, yeah.
Buzzo, back to you. Does it take anything special to take down a team like Trident? Now, you've already 3-0'd them. Is it more of a case of much of a muchness, or are you going to add a little bit more to this? Does it take anything special from you guys?
Much of a muchness?
Does it take anything more than usual to take these guys down in the grand final?
No, we just do our same thing. You know, we just basically play our game. Every single map, like you said, you know, different strategy, every single map and game type. So we just play the same way we played against every other team, I guess. Obviously, it's going to be a bit more hype and a bit more energy into this one because it's a grand final. But, you know, we just play the same.
All right. So, Damage, now you guys, as I said, you were taken down into the loser's bracket by Mindfreak. It was 3-0. Now, same question to you. Are you just going to try and do what you guys do? Is something got to change to turn this series score around?
Honestly, I think we do need a lot more intensity in this grand final. We've been fairly quiet throughout the entire tournament, and like I've been telling the boys, you know, we need to be more vocal and communicate more, be more intense about everything, more desperation, like with communication and whatnot. So yeah, we're going to bring that for this grand final, and we're just going to play the way we do and we should be fine.
All right, so both teams obviously very confident here. Now, again, got to repeat this question because those at home always love to know. Buzzo, get me in your headspace. How do you think this series is going to go when it comes to score? Are you guys just going to make it a complete 6-0 sweep, or do you see these guys taking a map?
Well, I think we're better at respawn than them. I think the addition of those guys, well, all of us together, I just think as a unit and as individual players, I think we're better. I've been told not to be cocky like that, but I think it's true. So, you know, maybe if they can get an S&D, I think S&D is always going to be close, but I think respawns are going to go in our favour. So probably 6-0, 6-1.
6-0. He's being generous giving you a map. How do you feel about that, Damage? How do you think the series score is going to go?
I honestly think we'll definitely bring back a fair few more maps. I'm not entirely sure like on the series score. I'm not going to make a prediction there, but we're looking to come in pretty hot and take a fair few maps back, maybe even win it.
All right, so Damage, forever humble. All right, so both of these guys are about to get set up for this grand final match. Those of you at home, I hope you're sitting on the edge of the seat. This is bound to be a good one. To take us into this grand final match, I'm going to throw it to our casters, BioAcid and Mikester.
Thank you, Maniac. Yes, BioAcid here, joined by Mikester, and it is setting into the grand final time here for ACL Brisbane. Mike, how are you feeling so far? You know, it's been a long weekend. But at the same time, there's been some upsets.
There has, and I mean, I think coming into this tournament, it was one of those predicted matchups for that final. Mindfreak always was up there in that final spot, and it was more about who's going to be up to the challenge to take them. Trident have risen. It's all about, you know, they're 3-0 down, but it's all about what they can do from this point onwards.
It is. Now, before the grand final gets underway, we have an announcement to make. Now, all weekend long, one of our sponsors, HyperX, thanks to them, had a giveaway running, and that giveaway has been drawn. The winner of that and the HyperX package is, of course, Fnatic. I believe he's from New Zealand, so a big congratulations to him on that via Twitter. Of course, he did tweet in at HyperX with the hashtag ACL HyperX and also his prediction. So a massive congratulations. You know, he's going to take home 16 gig of RAM there. You've obviously got the 240 gig hard drive, and it looks like down there that mouse pad as well. So a prize valued over $500.
That's just another thing I haven't won.
Yeah, I tried to win, but yeah, give me
it just
like just Just saying, you know, you'd think the fact that they were doing the giveaway, that they give it to us because we're here working for them, but apparently not. It doesn't work that way.
We just get overlooked.
But, you know, for those at home, those in the audience, be sure to help out and get involved with the poll. Now, of course, we've been running this poll all weekend long, trying to get your thoughts and your predictions in that regard as well to find out who you think would take out all the series we've been playing. So here we are once again. And look at that. I'm not sure if only one vote's come in or if no votes have come in, but 100% in favour of Trident right now. There we go. A bit more of it. Maybe they refreshed
the feed. They were just a little bit late to see the tweet and perhaps. The Trident fans pounced early.
I reckon what happened was that someone here in staff voted before the actual thing went live.
Ah, cheating.
Yeah, okay. A bit biased there. Probe aware.
Just to make it look good.
Probe aware. We'll blame him. But, you know, you can get involved at home. Like we said, use that keyword at ACL Pro followed by GFTRI for Trident or GFMF for Mind Freak. Now, of course, we're back to 50-50 again, you know. I think most will probably vote for the Mind Freak side of things here. But that being said, you know, Trident, exactly. You know, Trident are a team of players that have proved themselves time and time again. I'm sure they can do it here one more time. And obviously, as these players get set, ready for action in this grand final, we have to give one big shout-out again to our sponsors, the official sponsors of ACL Brisbane. Of course, Astro Gaming have helped us so much. We've had their listen-ins all weekend long. It's been the Astro booth here, Blue Mouth, running that one there by Dave. So a shout-out to him who have been, you know, providing equipment and stuff that's needed at the same time. You know, had products for sale at discount prices. So great gear all time around. And, of course, Astro now partnered with ACL. So you're going to see them more and more at each event.
Of course, big shout out to BenQ as well. Along the list, they're providing excellent displays throughout the year since 2009 here at the ACL events. Long-time sponsor. And I mean, this event wouldn't be, you know, the way it is without those displays.
Exactly right. And then, of course, the final one, HyperX, who, of course, has helped out in regards to the whole streaming site, the PC equipment, and helping us out to give you, those at home and those in the audience, the chance to watch this at the best quality that you possibly can, and, of course, the VODs later to come. I want to give a little side special shout-out, though, to all the production and all staff for ACL, without whom none of this would be possible. So, you know, these guys put in the time and the effort that involved was set up, you know, the volunteers that come along as well, you know, before we get... We usually do this after the match, but I'm going to do it beforehand while we have the more viewers, so everyone more hears it more often, but, you know... A production team here on Alpha, the production team for Bravo as well, because we did have two streams for COD alone.
For the first time.
And this was a console-only event as well. You know, we only had COD and Halo. Halo's still going on upstairs. It'll probably keep going until about 10 o'clock tonight.
Shout out to them, Citadel and Trident, taking it on.
Yeah, big games happening up there, obviously, from that Halo side of things. But these guys are getting set, ready for action. I believe they are. Oh, they were looking all good to go. I was about to start it up and someone left. But, you know, those polls, 76% to 24 right now. In favour of Mind Freak. Back and forth it's going here, Mike Star. But, you know, most people will be like, Bio, what's your prediction? Oh, you know, my predictions are pretty standard when it comes to this sort of stuff. What are you predicting though, Mike Star?
I'm actually going to be interested to see what you think as well, but I'm going to be leading for a Mind Freak win. Now, I'm not going to be saying, you know what, Buzzard was suggesting a 6-0 or 6-1. I'm going to be giving a couple more maps to try. And okay. I think they can go on a roll, but once again, you know, Damage mentioned it himself. They need to be more, you know, motivated to win. You know, communication is key. They need to bring that up, step that up a little bit, and go from there. If they can do that, I can see them putting maps on the board and making a bit more of a close contested match.
Well, hopefully they do, because obviously, you know, no one really enjoys watching as much as everyone else. You know, you don't really want to watch the 3-0, 6-0 sort of match. You want to see it come down right to the wire, intense moments, all right down to the last few seconds in each game. And that's what you like to see in any grand final or any match in general. Of course, CTF Biolab will be the first map because it is continuation. So it is 3-0 at the moment in favour of Mindfreak, as stated during that pre-match interview. So, you know, Mindfreak do have that lead because they did verse this team of Trident in the winner's bracket final earlier on today. And, of course, S&D Solar, Hardpoint, Biolab. Now, Mike, though, he's tipping, like we said, you know, he's given some more maps to the Trident team. So we should see some more maps come into play as well. We do have the rotation here in front of us. So S&D Detroit, Uplink Comeback, CTF Ascend, Hardpoint Detroit, and S&D Biolab to finish it off if it comes down all the way. Look at the audience there. They got their little clappers involved. They're all pretty pumped. So I want to hear that when the big play happens, when someone clutches or someone goes off, I want to hear all those little clappers go off as well in the background. Because if I don't hear them, the audience isn't getting involved enough, in my opinion.
And likely someone's going to get fired for just not having that grand an idea from them being there.
Yeah, you know, I spoke to some of the guys that are in the States, some of the casters and production team, and they all say they want these sort of things at more events. They want the clappers there. They want people involved in the games because it makes it more intense. You know, you see this sort of stuff at LOL events and StarCraft events. There we go. Hit each other with them, you know, go nuts. Why not?
Someone's getting a beating.
Someone's going to get their eye poked out. You know, it's all fun and games until someone loses an eye, and no one might, like, it'll probably be me somehow.
even though you're in a completely separate room, and it's still gonna wind up.
Mike to, hits to me when we're off you. Camera, just so everyone knows.
It is a secret. Don't reveal secrets. What happens in production stays in production.
We are still getting ready for this matchup. But look at that poll. Stores haven't changed that much in favour of Mindfreak. So I hope everyone in the audience and those watching at home have got their votes in. You know, I'm of course am tipping Mindfreak for the W here. I feel that they'll be able to close this one out as well. You know, I'm thinking maybe 6-1. You know, I don't want to take anything away from Trikes. I know Trident are a strong team. And yeah. I know their slaying power is right out there as well. But I just feel, yeah, like Buzzin said, you know, the way that they play together and singularly with Mindfreak, it's one of those little things that has set them apart for so long.
And tossing back on that, you mentioned about a 6-1, but do you think the maps themselves are going to be close, or do you think they're going to be more one-sided?
I think S&Ds should be close. I feel that some of the like hardpoint respawn should be close as well. Uplink 2, or CTF I'm not too sure about right now. You know, obviously, I feel that Mindfreak should be able to get a couple more caps in that regard. So we'll find it, obviously, in the first game because that is going to be a CTF on Biolab, but I'm just not too sure how close Trident will see. If Trident can pick up some extra caps there, you know, a bit of map control, then it should be a close all-round series.
It really should. And, I mean, for me, I personally believe that Mindfreak will actually walk away a little bit more over into the hardpoint modes themselves.
69.
But... yeah, I mean, right in the gut.
I don't care. I don't care how old you get. It's always going to be funny.
Yeah.
I'm immature, I know, but I will laugh.
I think
every
the older
time.
You get, the funnier it gets.
I think
at the same
so.
Time.
I think that's the way it works. Yeah. Aw, it's down to 60. That's no fun. 68.
Right, so I think Bioacid would like a couple more people to be voting for Mindfreak right
yeah,
now to go
just
back
one more. I want one more. Yeah. But it looks like everyone's in the lobby now. I think that they're good to go. We'll just confirm that before we actually start up, because I don't want to prematurely happen and start for these guys before they are ready, due to the fact that we'll then have to end it once again. But it seems that we're all good to go. You'll see the guys pop their headphones on now, get set.
Here
come a couple of fives, you know. Come on, boys. Good luck. A bit of a miss hit there with Beeson and Fate. But for those who don't know, actually, just quickly take you through it. That's Fate, Chillions, Beeson, and Damage on your screens right there. Obviously, you know that it is the Trident team, but in case you didn't know who is who, there you are.
And out of this whole lobby as well, 7 out of the 8 people have competed internationally overseas as well.
Very true.
So I just wanted to point that one out. Beeson, the only one who doesn't have that experience. But when you're surrounded by, you know, in a lobby of superstar players here from our region, it's hard to not expect a high-class game.
You know, talking about Beeson being the only player who hasn't competed on an international level, we're going to give him first look here heading into this one. Game number one of the grand final.
You're going to see them, of course, rotating over to that first hard point. Beeson will be looking over to this purple side. He'll get stunned on one and he'll try to go for some shots in early as well, but he will get taken out. It's 3 plays down from Trident, though. Mindfreak opening up to a great start. Damage there, but
I think he's on holidays. He's checking out the sights right now. Just chilling out here in open snow. He sees the flag getting grabbed. Trident going to cut it off there in the mid. Thanks to the teammate shots there from Fate as well. We'll slow that run down. Fate will get the return in the first 30 seconds. Hands were on by Mindfreak, but the Trident team had none of it, getting their flag return.
I was a little bit slow to realize that we are starting to capture the flag, but the players were on point. So he was watching over through the angle. And I mean, Damage, once again, is playing a little bit of that defensive angle. You do notice, though, the players from Mindfreak try to be a little bit aggressive after they got those first couple of kills, but then they sort of backfired on them. They pushed a little bit too far, got slaughtered down, and we're back over to that stalemate situation straight off those respawns. You notice Buzzin, though, is going to seemingly try to assist his teammates to actually go on forward. That was actually Dent's my mistake. And there, as he goes forward for that double kill, Fighter picks up a single as well, and they're going to be rotating over through this purple side, trying to go in for this capture. One player is going to be going for the contest, though. He takes down one, but can Dent make it in time? Yes, he can. And that's a minute 10 capture.
I was a bit concerned there for Dent, because he did hit that stomp down a bit too early, just a little about a meter too early, but he still managed to get that flag in. The player wasn't right on his heels, though, as Trident now did try and grab that flag and go for a run of their own. You'll see 4 players getting dropped there. Damage, flag in hand. His teammates are around him. He's going to watch out for this respawn side, though. One player coming out of the red spawn onto green. It was going to be Fighter who took him down, and she'll get that flag return. Now, this team of Mindfreak again going for a counter cap here. Dan's running a green side out wide. Look at that minimap there. No one really going to stop him if his teammates can help out. Those cuts down the middle. Stomps down again. Ooh. There it is for Mindfreak, 2-0 lead.
Convincing start for Mindfreak right now, and it only has been 2 minutes into the game right here. You're going to be seeing, of course, kills trading out as well. Chillians was able to finally take down one, but and he also has the flag, so he's going to be running it over through this green side, of course, as he's going to be trying to rely, he's going to have his teammates that he needs to rely in to be able to pick off these kills. And you notice the blue arrows are just going off across the map here. He's about to be intercepted by 3. He gets tagged, and he's trying to go for the kill. He still gets them. His team gets the kills as well, but he still will get taken. That one player
left up. Fighter gets wide, gets two. And unfortunately, he just can't get the third.
Almost that third person, but he's still got the flag returned for his team. So it is going to be still 2-0 in favor of Mindfreak here. Fate did grab that flag and tried to take it out of there, but did not get far. Didn't have the support from his teammates in that vicinity. And once again, you know, Mindfreak trying to capitalize on that situation. The other team does not have the setup that they need to run flags. Mindfreak takes advantage of that and will run a flag of their own. Damage is out juking. I think it was Beeson who was around there. And now Buzzin comes in to get a two-piece. That's three flags to none right now in favor of Mindfreak.
You can outduke whoever you want, but if you can't get those flags captured, you're doing it wrong right here. As Dez takes down one, but he can't get the second. He also got a return to his name just then as well. And you notice, I mean, a couple of kills are rolling in the favor of Trident, but they need to get these flag captures captured. Now you notice Beastland, he picked up the flag, he went over to the catwalk, but he just couldn't make anything out of it. Mindfreak's defense has been just as good as their offense. And I mean, you look at that and it's 3-0, so that must be damn good.
It is. Shocks and damage, however, both with flags in hand, running flags at each other. Demi's aware what's going on there. He decides to back step a little bit, but a few players are pushing up from the Mindfreak team now on him. They're all around him. They see him around here. If Demi's getting the two-piece, oh, it would have been great for him. But once again, it's going to be Dens who has that flag and is running it. He's going to go high blue. One player there in front of him to stop him. He's going short work of Beaston. His teammate with the escort there too. 4-0 right now in favor of this Mindfreak team. And right now, Mike's up. Almost 4 minutes gone in the first half. 4-0. It's pretty much a cap a minute.
I mean, that is exactly right. It is a capture per minute right here. And I mean, they're going to be looking to continue that trend by getting the fifth capture in the fifth minute right here. We're on board with Dens as he's going to be looking to pick off a couple of kills over on the Biolab. Shox picks off one as well. And they're looking and they're hunting to pick off these kills. Now, damage will take that one. It was on the turret.
That's what I do in this sort of situation. I come with the turret and go ham.
I do believe there's a little bit of a difference, though, between Bioacid playing Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and these kind of players.
No, maybe a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Just a smidge. But right now, here with Buzzin, just on this defensive side of things, he's keeping an eye out for any of these trying players that might push up and try and run that flag again. Buzzin aware no one else is in the vicinity, decides to return the flag for his team while the rest of them push on up. And look at that mini-map, bringing it up large for you all. So we see Buzzin down bottom right where their flag is located. We have Fighter who is pushing up right now. Two players of Trident who are in that vicinity to stop him and slow him down. And then Dan's just chilling out here in Tower in the bottom section of it out near Elbow. Decides not really do much in this situation, so they let that clock run out. And they'll take it into the second half with a 4-0 lead here, Meister.
They might be leading 4-0, but I was a little bit disappointed they didn't get that fifth capture in the fifth minute.
It would have been good to keep the momentum happening. I agree.
It really would have, and you're going to be seeing that half end with three of the Mindfreak players down. Just going to be giving some, you know, just some fist bumps all around, keeping that hype up for themselves as well. They still seem calm. You know, they're not overly excited. They're just doing it like every other day.
Yeah, well, that's exactly right. You know, this is what we heard with by Buzzard in that pre-match interview. You know, it's pretty much of a muchness, as he said. You know, you're not going to add any extra. Not going to take anything away. It's going to play it how they usually play it and see how they go in that sort of situations. It's working out for them well so far. Trident, on the other hand, you know, if it looks like, you know, damage. 16-11, he's got the kills up there, but Fate, Beaston and Chilean need to pick up a few more kills and we should see that tight turn.
It definitely does seem from the last couple of matches we have seen against these guys in the previous match we saw them play. You know, one player is generally doing excelling, but they need every single one of their players, all four of them, to play on point at 110% for them to stand a chance against a team like Mindfreak. But you see with this second half started, still 4-0 being that scoreline, of course, but the kills rolling in favour of Mindfreak. Primarily.
Yeah, looking at that Mindfreak side, when we're talking about kills, you know, 17 and 10 for Dens, Shocks on 18 and 12, 12 and 15 for Fighter, and then 11 and 8. You know, Buzzin usually would have some more kills there. Dens' two-piece, though, will have been pushed up a little bit here. Fire picks up the third kill there, so Demi's now the only man left alive here for the time being as they go into the back into the Vial Lab. He decided against actually going out and running that flag. He decided to push back a little bit here. Beaston down in their opposition side in that flag locally, and just like that, they push in the middle part here, the Trident squad. They're setting themselves up for a chance at a flag run here. They're working together. Demi's going to run that one now. He's got teammates escort him both through mid and both through his cuts. Oh, just shots from outside there by Buzzin to stop that flag run.
Chilean's going to have that flag though, and he's going to get intercepted there at five. Dens will have the other flag though, and he goes to go through purple, takes down Beaston and his teammate Shocks, but unfortunately he gets taken down shortly after that.
He did, you know, he had his teammate Fighter and Shocks there to help him out, and it was a bit of a risky move he had to make. He was shooting through Shocks, or let Shocks try and get the kill and perhaps die at the same time. So he went with the shoot through option, ask questions later instead. Didn't work out for him though, but you know, most times that has worked for Mindfreak, where their flag has gotten taken, they've got the return, they've then counter-capped on top of Trident and giving themselves a bit more of a lead each time.
Den's being able to pick up an interesting kill right there as he goes for the stun. Unfortunately, getting taken down. That flag is going to be returned. Just their fighter missing crucial shots, and he will get taken. That's three players down from Mindfreak now. While they might be respawning quite soon, it's all about getting that flag out. Damage was able to go ahead and get that run off to the green platform. Now, player's going to be intercepting there at orange, but it's all about being able to run it past. You notice on the minimap, player's going to be there to intercept, get that return, and now the flag's back at base.
Yeah, Shock's down there waiting in the corner. Some players like to just wait for that flag runner to happen. We're almost down to the final quarter now. 2:50 on the clock remaining here in the second half of CTF Biolab. And right now, it's still looking very much like a Mindfreak map for them to take here. And I think a lot of the time we have said it, it's currently Mindfreak's map to lose being 4-0 up.
Shock's having this flag, though, going to be looking to pull it through that blue side, getting taken down. Flag once again returned, but 2.5 minutes remaining. We're down to the final quarter of the game, and Trident still have not yet put a flag on the board. Now, Chilians has this flag, though, and is getting pretty close to being able to do so. Now, with no one left to really go ahead and get that flag returned, it's going to be a capture. And finally, just as I was doubting them, they're putting that flag on. So it's 4-1, still three more flags left, though. With only 2 minutes remaining, they're going to need to go double time.
That'll definitely be a confidence booster, too, for the Trident team, you know, having now finally put a flag in and getting it all the way home. It's going to pump them up a little bit, and hopefully it's enough just to change the momentum here. They've still got 2 minutes, and all they need is 3 caps. So it's still possible. It is doable. You know, nothing's out of reach here, but they've really got to improve their shots and pick up any extra kill and win all their gun battles right now to be able to pull this one off. But right now, it's Shocks with that flag trying to run it out. He is glowing red. He's around the barrel. He decides to pretty much kill himself but take out Chillings at the same time. And just like that, Fate will get cleaned up as well. So both flags should get sent back home. They will. We have a minute 30 left, 35 left on the clock with a 3-point gap. Mindfreak still in that lead. Den's about to hit 30 kills.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to be having that flag, of course, picked up by Beaston trying to run that in with only 90 seconds remaining. This is where things get interesting. 30 seconds of cap is what they need to tie it back up as Dens will also pick up the flag. Of course, he's the only one with the flag now as Chillians, actually. You know, Chillians will now pick that one up as well, but you're going to be seeing Dens being contested. Now, they're going to be running opposite sides of the map, and each respective team is going to try and get their own flag back, but it does seem with Mindfreak were more successful than Trident. That makes it 5-1, and that makes likely the final nail in the coffin.
I think I have to agree with you right there, Mike. So, you know, Buzzin and Fighter have really helped that run. Dens was hit a few times and, you know, he just sort of out-juked the players from Trident. He allowed his teammates to catch up to where he was and help out with that flag run, giving him that support, allowing him to put that flag in. So, Fighter doing that scoreline, back in again, a 4-point deficit that Trident are down by here. They've got 38 seconds left on the clock. You know, it's not going to be out of doable. I think Trident are aware of that, but at the same time, they aren't going to obviously give up without a fight. They're going to still put pressure on this flag, try and grab it, and perhaps go for one more run, as does Dens. He decides to run this flag out green, tries to head up high, can't do it, though he'll get shut down by Fate at that time, and both flags will head back home.
Yeah, I mean, with that final 20 seconds remaining, of course, both teams know the final result of that game, likely looking to be a 5-1 scoreline as well, even though Trident are going to try maybe run in a quick flag capture. Seems unlikely, but that is going to be the map regardless. Mindfreak 4-0. Now, that's a respawn done. Of course, we'll be moving to a map 5 after that, a search and destroy bio. It's going to be on Solar, and I mean, Mindfreak, they started, you know, Buzzin stated earlier, their respawns, they feel they're better, but it's a search and destroy next.
Buzzin, I think Buzzin was trying to go for a sneaky 3-0 just then, but then he was like, oh, I'll turn that into, like, I'm stretching my fingers, guys, don't worry about me.
Yeah, I think maybe he forgot that he was first to 6. Yeah. Couldn't do that on one hand.
Obviously 5-1 at the end of the CTF side of things. I can hear that. I can hear those little clappers going off out there, so the audience getting behind the players here as well as we head into the S&D on Solar. Like I said before, any clutch plays or any 1v4 clutch that goes off here or any two-piece and stuff like that, I want to hear those clappers go as well at the same time. Don't worry about the players. They can't hear anything. They've got those noise-canceling headphones on. That's what they're designed for. They're not designed to not hear us. They're designed to not hear those clappers.
And both.
No. Just not us.
I don't think they want to really be listening to you at the same time, if I'm honest. Either way, though, I mean, the players from Mindfreak still, you know, still calm, collected, and restrained at the moment. I don't feel they've shown their full potential either. I don't think they've needed to at this current stage. Whereas Trident, you know, they're struggling a little bit per game. You notice a couple of players, they're highlight players, they're standing out and they're doing well. The other ones, you know, a little bit, some lacking behind a little bit, and then, you know, it's not really working for them.
Oh, it's not, and we'll have to see if it's going to change anything up here coming into this S&D and if it'll work for them at the same time. Now, I felt that, you know, if it was going to be a map that the team of Trident is going to take, it would be the S&D side of things. I sort of felt that, yeah, the CTF would go in favour of the team of Mindfreak, and at the same time, you know, I think that it'll be a close hardpoint game as well. I think that that sort of stands out on its own, but I feel that Mindfreak should be able to close that. So if Mindfreak takes this S&D out, I feel it will only see the game of a three happen in the hardpoint biolab, and that'll be game, set, match. But, you know, if Trident can get this one and take it to an extra game, then, you know, they can then take an S&D on Detroit following that hardpoint on biolab, and then perhaps come back in an uplink. So, yeah, it's still anyone's game, but it's really, you know, like we said many times, Mindfreak series to lose here.
Yeah, I mean, you look at the votes as well, I think they have to agree with you. 68% there for Mindfreak. Still stuck on that number that you're not too happy about. Oh. Trident, 32% as well. And I mean, to vote, tweet at ACL Pro using the key for Trident, GFTRI, and for Mindfreak, GFMF.
You know, I'd like to get involved with that voting, but we have to be unbiased here. And if I was to vote, I'd probably...
No one will ever know.
I would vote for both. I need like a separate account I can just tweet from.
So no one knows it's you?
Yeah, so we can just vote for random things. I don't know. Anyone got a spare Twitter account? Let me know. Just send us a DM me the details.
Or you can just, on BioAcid's behalf, go ahead and start voting his votes.
Yeah, do that. Vote for both the teams for me. I should actually just get the ACL Pro details and tweet for, and vote off that account.
I have organisation domination right now. I think I might be able to sway a team's vote one way.
You know, I wonder if Rob's got like all the Does Play accounts and he's using them at the same time as like GFMF. Like he has like 8 votes in one hit.
That's probably cheating.
Of course, quick little shout out there to the Does Play team who have been inviting stats via Does Play Stats all weekend long. You can find them either via Twitter at Does Play Stats or via the interwebs doesplay.com/ACL Brisbane.
Great stats, by the way. I had a little bit of a look at them as well. They've been doing a great job working tirelessly over the weekend.
I hope that he's put my down for that game that Hysteria played on my account. So BioAcid should have a bunch of good kills there.
It's only one game. I don't think that counts.
No, it should.
I definitely don't think
into
it
the
is.
S&D we go, though, as these guys get set up for this first round. It is that Mindfreak team on the attack, and it looks like they are going to head to their more favoured side of B when you do have all your players left up and alive. Fighter going for that bank shot nade. Doesn't find anyone inside there. Thanks to COD Vision, we can see a player at the back, however. Oh, here comes some late defence nades, though. Just trying to test the water to see if anyone's there putting that bomb down. No takers on it, however. So that's going to give Fighter the okay to perhaps move in and get this bomb down. He'll do so. Hightail out of there, staying alive. Ooh. Just for the hair on his chin.
You're going to be seeing, of course, having him rotate back over to that glass side. Buzzin will be able to take down Chilli, and his damage takes down Buzzin in return. 3v3 situation. Shots go out in the back, though. His Dense takes down Beast. Now tag with the sniper, I do believe that was from Fate. As you see him pushing on through, it's 26 seconds remaining still on the clock. It's a 2v3.
Yeah, still plenty of time there. His teammate, however, just got taken down by Shock. There's the sniper again. He finds the hit, and Kagul's confirmed on fire that time around. Again, scope is out, trying to hunt down a player. Using that thermal sight, he sees a couple of shots coming from the middle. Ooh, doesn't connect the shot. He gets taken out by the side, which I think was Shox who picked him up. And that round will go to 1-0.
Yeah, you're going to see on this round, the cool camp Shox from his perspective, just being able to just play calm. His teammate was causing a little bit of destruction. He poked back out, got the kill, and was able to get the round for himself as well. Now, you mentioned about, you know, Trident. Possibly, if they're going to take a map, it's going to be the Search and Destroy. They haven't opened up to a great start.
Well, they haven't, but at the same time, it wasn't like a fall down and none of them got a kill.
And it was only the first round.
They got a couple of kills in that one, so I'll give them credit in that regard. So Fate's going to be the bomb carrier this round in, so it looks like it will be a B push. Now, this is one of the maps, for those watched earlier on, you do see if Chilians grabs the bomb, usually a A push in that regard. So just keep that in mind from what we saw earlier on today. But right now, Fate, bomb in hand, 3v3 situation as Fighter picks up Chilians.
Going to be, of course, having with that bomb in hand. You know, Fate's going to be the one to really need to make these plays here, but Beastland's going to take down Fighter. So it's a 2v3 situation. They've got the numbers, and you notice Fate, you know, he's going to be relying on that long range with the Maws to maybe pick off kills, a couple of crossovers as well, swapping over to Shox. He was able to take down the kill there on Beastland, making it into a 2v2 situation. Fate still has that bomb in hand as well. So it's all about, you know, where he wants to go. He's going to call that out to his teammate. His teammates are then going to try and set up around that as well, get a secure location to maybe be able to get that bomb down. And Shox, I mean, I do believe he spotted something and got a couple of shots out.
Yeah, he put those shots in there, but it looks like at the same time they are thinking maybe they're still over here at B trying to distract us. They realise no one's actually down on that B bomb site at this time being, so it looks like they're going to get the OK to perhaps push on up and perhaps put that bomb down here in a moment. 27 seconds left on the clock, still a 2v2. Maybe they left it too late though as a player. Is that Shox or is that Dens? It looks like it's Shox right there on the outside. Dens now getting the call to come over here as well. Den picks that one. Can Den get the second? He doesn't need to. Shox will do it instead. And the second round will go to Mindfreak now, making it 2-0. Dens just pretty much having a bit of a party and a congratulation round there with Shox.
Yeah, I think he's matching his gamertag right here with Mercedes. Dens is getting a couple of dances out, getting a couple of shots out as well. And I mean, they're all just laughs and smiles right here, team of Mindfreak.
These guys get set for round number 3 now. So they, of course, will be on the attack once again, the defending side. Just want to quickly scroll through all the players here. So see what they're running in regards to some overkills there. Doesn't look like anyone running the overkill side of things, but Shox does have that IMR out, so I'll stay with him for the time being to see if he can get some long-range shots on any of these Trident players. So they look to head to V this round in.
Of course, you're going to be having a couple of nades go out over into the B room as well. It's not going to be able to pick off any tags just yet. And he's going to be aiming one high up at the same time. Now, still no tags from him, and none of the other Mindfreak players were successful with their entry frags, but he's still going to be having these trying to play spread out a little bit. A snapshot does go off in the background. The nade nearly takes down Shox, but nearly isn't going to be good enough. He's going to back out, get a couple of get a little bit of health back as Buzzin takes down Chilean at the same time. So it's a 4v3, and you actually notice from the minimap, the players from Trident, you know, trying to spread out, trying to get a good angle, and Mindfreak Shox just being able to do whatever he wants on the map.
Yeah, and obviously with that mute enabled, allowing him to be quiet. He comes up behind there, and one of the players looks going to be damaged. One more player in front, and on Fate, I think that was. He finds to pick up the two kills. Look at them again. Big smiles coming out. They're enjoying it. They know that they've pretty much got this one as well. If they keep this up, 3-0 to the Mindfreak team. And Shox that final two-piece at the end, even though he got hit by two nades.
It's just the shot that missed, and Shox is probably like, what is he doing? What, yeah, how can I just get that? How is that real life?
So we head into round number four now here. Look at that, 6-0 for Shox at the moment. 2-2 there for Fighter. Benton's on 2-0, then 2-2 for Buzzin. You know, some kills have to come out from Chilean. It's currently on that 0 on the donut. Breadsticks following there for both Fate and Beast in 2. Damaged anyone for 2 kills from that side of things in regards to the Trident team. So Fate rumble with him. Scope is out. They're pushing towards this right-hand side here at B. And I feel if they put the bomb down quickly and then try to set up at the defensive, then it may work better off in their favor because these slow pushes just don't seem to be doing it.
It doesn't seem to be working at all. Damage being able to take out the first kill there on Fighter as Fate once again still with this bomb. Going to be just peeking over, wanting to get that pick off early. Now Dent is there. He's getting a couple of shots that will be able to take it down, which means bomb is down at the same time. Now Damage is going to maybe look to rotate over, pick that one up. No, looks to the back. He's going to get taken out by the flanking player. Now Beeson's all alone in a 1v3 situation. Will Is he about to see one? No, Dens decides to stay put. It's going to be difficult ahead, difficult road ahead here for Beast. And 3-0 is already scoreline as well, so they really need a round.
Just showing that minimap where all these players are right now. So you can see as I highlight them yellow. You can see where Beast is, of course. One player now challenging him from back factory. Dens is there as well. He's in a little bit of a sticky spot here. Could not move around. Dens pokes out right at the last moment, but they didn't need to worry too much about it. The kill already happened. 4-0 that scoreline. And again, Shox, he loves his final kill cam. He seems to be hogging it all. At this time being, he's currently 7-0 on the kill on the scoreboard there, followed up by, I think it was Buzzin on 4-0.
Yeah, I'm just speechless right now.
Oh, it was Den, sorry.
We were thinking about Trident being able to take out Search and Destroy out of any of the other maps in the rotation. I mean, maybe they're just not too great at solar. Either way, they need to get a couple of good rounds here if they want to stand a chance here. Round 5 loading on up, and it already is 4-0. And as you mentioned, you know, two of the players
Mason.
From Mindfreak still haven't died, as I say that. Beeson going to be the one to shut him down.
Yeah, Beeson, this is what the Trident team need. You know, they need to get those first blood, and a double first blood, realistic like that, is going to help them out and improve them. Chilling is now challenging here, pushing perhaps a bit too far. He decides against it. He knows there's still two players left instead of just the one, and they're usually together in that sort of situation. Fate comes in from behind, though, to come down on Buzzin. So now it's Shox in a 1v3. Fate, Damage, and Chilean's all still alive. Ooh. Shox sees him, but knew he probably couldn't connect on the kill. Sees Fate up high, takes on him, but Fate outshoots him, making it now 4-1. First round there for Trident. Can they mount this comeback?
All right, maybe they can. You know, they've gotten around. It's a stepping stone to being able to do what they need to do. And I mean, of course, remember, the overall series scoreline for those who might just be tuning in is 4-0 to Mindfreak. So this is a much-needed map because you don't want to let a team like Mindfreak have, you know, that 5-0 advantage or 5-anything advantage, because all it needs is one map. And from there, all it takes is one mistake to be able to lose that. So they need to focus on everything from this point onwards. Go for the comeback on this map and then go for the comeback in the series in return.
I'm going to start chilling some love right now here on the stream to see if he can pick up a kill for us to get off the bat. I did it earlier on today with Textbook Black and Zeus, who was struggling to find a kill on the exact same map in S&D. So we'll see if it helps him out. Oh, I thought he had that one, but he did not connect with all those shots. It's going to be fire to take him out. Fate does connect on Buzzin, however, to make it now a 3v3 left here in the round. 1 minute left on the clock in round number 6. There's Fate. Long shots to find Dens. Decides against putting that bomb down straight away. He's going to hope that it'll draw out another MF player and they can get another kill. But watch it. Here comes Fighter from back factory there. Fighter sees him. Fighter puts shots and takes him down.
You're going to be seeing, of course, Damage now on your screens, looking for that player at that back factory size. Still going to be there, but knowing the player that Damage was checking out, and he's going to be all alone here as well. With the bomb being down, he's up against two players. He's really going to be searching for a pick up early. Ooh. Now, he's able to take down the first kill there on Shox, making it into a 1v1 now. It's going to be fine to take him down, and
He was so red.
That was just just the butterfly lands on him, basically.
Pretty much. You know, he was extremely red during that exchange, and he was not going to last very long at all. And you'll probably see one bullet connects, and that's all it takes.
He didn't even have enough time for a tag. That's how quick it was, and that's how red he was.
That's all he needed. And right there, you'll see now, heading into round number 7. Could be the final round here if Mindfreak can close it in S&D-wise. We'll find out if they can do it now here on their attack once again. Now, we saw him hit A pretty quickly last time, and that's where they actually lost the round. So maybe it'll change up and they'll go back to B again, what would work for him in the past, or perhaps they'll just do a split.
Either way, of course, we are going to be seeing the Mindfreak team come over to this A side. Now, Sharks will get taken down on early, which means the bomb is down as well. Three players up from the Mindfreak team. We're going to be looking to recover that as well. Dens will fall. Fighter and Buzzin are going to be on the other side of the map at the same time. So they're going to be maybe looking to pick off a couple on early, and that's going to be Buzzin taking down Fate. So they're taking down one. One more down will make it into a 2v2, and that's what they're going to be searching for. But as you can see, Fighter is just going to be doubling back, and Buzzin's going to be doing the same to try and recover that bomb.
Obviously, you know, you see Fighter now, Buzzin, they both got their calls for a comeback. Let's just regroup a little bit here. The bomb is dropped down there at Glass. We can see that on the minimap, thanks to CODvision. We know what's going on here in broadcaster mode, but obviously the players do not. Oh, he sees him shots there. We'll find Chillians now. And a good move here by Fighter from MF, you know, just getting the kill, hightailing it out of there, keeping the other team guessing on where you are. He's going to try and escort Buzzin now across and down to this bomb site and see if they can get set up to get this bomb planted. Changing the other team now, Beeson keeping himself between the two, as does Damage. They're just going to try and keep eyes on both these bomb sites because they don't want to give it up and allow these guys to get the bomb down.
2v2 situation, time running out. Of course, players going to be trying to get this rotation down and happening for them. That's going to be Beeson getting the shot on one as he gets a couple of shots behind. He's actually not able to connect here. Last player alive here, Fighter. It's amazing, a 1v1. Now, Damage will be the last one for that. He's going to begin that rotation, but will he go for that contest? That is going to be the question. 1 second, Damage. He was rotating, but he just couldn't even get there quick enough.
I'm surprised Demi didn't just chill in the middle somewhere and be like, okay, let's just let the time run out. But I guess at the same time, he's like, he may have just had enough time to get the bomb down. So that's why obviously he pushed for that. But that round will go in favor of the Trident team and now allowing them to stay alive in the S&D here. Are still Chillians, you know, 0-6. You'd hope that he'll pick up a couple of kills here, but right now, because the rest of the Trident guys are doing the work. But we'll see what's going to happen here in this next round.
We will indeed, of course, as you are going to be having the team of Trident on this attack. They're going to be looking to favor over him to this right side of the map as well. Damage, he's going to be having that Mauls once again. Not going to have a thermal on that, just going to be the single shot. And none of the players from Mindfreak wanting to be going for any high jumps at any time soon.
Yeah, Damage going for that long, deep nade there to try and find someone back B. Doesn't get a tag on it, though. The rest of the players from his team here with him, though, they're trying to push up towards the B-bomb site to perhaps put this bomb down. Oh, does he see him there? They're both looking at the exact same area. I don't think he does. Neither does Denzo. I was to call out what happened there. So we'll just see changing over to Fate, see if he can find anyone on with his Maws in the scope. Yeah, there's Damage on Den. He's finally found him in the end, though, picking up that kill. And now allowing Beeson to push up to find Buzzin. That's two players gone from the round. They need to pick up this, they put this bomb down and get the last one. There it is there. Fight will drop as well. And try and pick up another round here. 5-3, getting this comeback into play.
Yeah, I mean, they were able to get that one for themselves. And once again, just crucial rounds that they need, leaving it a little bit late. But, I mean, better late than never.
That's exactly right, you know. Obviously, you want to try. Well, it is better late than never. But perhaps they would have liked to have done it before Mindfreak got to 6 and set a match point for a while here. But we'll find out now if this round will be the last one. Chillian's finding the scoreboard there, finding himself at 1-6 now. So that's going to help these guys out. And perhaps if he can pick up some more kills, even more rounds will go in their favor.
Of course, we are going to be having, with Mindfreak pushing over to this right side, Trident's actually going to be matching them with, you know, these players pushing as well. Shots to go out. They know there's a giant contest here. Player from either team does drop in the fight, as we do have Dens being able to take that one, and Fighter staying alive magically somehow.
I honestly thought Fighter was going to die. That's why I changed the shocks, because he probably should have, and I think everyone else in the game thought the same. But now Beeson in a 1v2 up against Dens and Shocks here. Beeson's going to check the bomb site there, finds the one. Oh, he may have saw that nade come out. He did. He knows that he's right there beside him. He decides to hightail back a little bit now. Shocks not too sure what he should do. Should he go for the plant? Should he go for the rotate? Should he go for the challenge? Beeson's going to sit back and just try and stay in equal ground here between the two bomb sites. He realizes now the bomb's gone down at B. He's going to come out and try and find it.
I mean, Beeson needs to go huge in this clutch right now. 1v1 situation up against Shock. Shock's just going to rotate around. He's going to see him. He's going to take him. That's going to be 6-3.
Shock saw him at the back door there. He saw him come on through. So that's why he went for that rotate quickly. Came around while he pushed on through. And like you said, 6-3, the S&D will finish up at. And it'll go in favor of the Mindfreak team. So Mindfreak, one game away from closing out the series and winning this grand final, and of course winning ACL Brisbane for 2015. It's going to be a hard point on Biolab, and you know, I still tip Mindfreak to take this out, but I thought the hard point will be a close one.
I definitely have to agree with you on that. And I'm not going to lie, it wasn't the result that I was thinking it was going to be leading up into this. I mean, the first couple of rounds just opened it up for Mindfreak. They're able to go well. At the same time, I mean, Mindfreak, they were just able to, you know, always push forward. Trident, it's still, you know, every time we get a camera shot on them, it doesn't look like that, you know, the points that Damage is talking about in that pre-game interview, that they've been doing that. It doesn't seem like that communication's open. It seems like they're a little bit down in the dumps. And it doesn't seem like that they, you know, they onto that hype level and that motivation to get them this win.
No, I definitely agree with you there. And obviously with that beautiful view behind us there of Brisbane here at Southbank, it's lovely to be here. And we might be wrapping up soon if Trident can't enter back as we head into game number 3 in this series, but 6 in the overall side of things. I guess you look at it like that, obviously. And if it does go in Mindfreak's favour, then that'll be done and dusted, and Mindfreak will be crowned 2015 champs of ACL Brisbane.
Yeah, I mean, for the first event, of course, on the national circuit to be a 6-0 win, it's, you know, I think they were expecting something
else.
It'll be
APAC all over again for them.
Yeah, it really will be. I mean, that's definitely a great point. They've been going pretty good in our regional events, the ones that they attend anyway. And I mean, coming off Gfinity as well, they wanted to hit it off with the bang.
They really needed to, obviously, after that Gfinity experience. Obviously, you know, they didn't perform how they wanted to. They weren't getting the kills they needed to at that event, and it just showed overall. As we now head into this one, perhaps the final game in this series, as we have said. No change, start things off with the Mindfreak squad over this side of things, and as they head into that first hard point.
Of course, your enemy having, of course, the first points go into Trident's favour, as we do have Damage picking off these kills as well. Beastland, just constant kills. No play from Mindfreak, apart from just then, was able to actually get kills. Buzzin was the first one to do so, and we saw that there on his screen. Fortunately, he'll get taken down as well. Dent's trying to break in through the side. He'll get taken. Shock's contesting. He'll drop as well. So Trident getting the first 20 points without dropping a single one. Now, with that being said, it's all up. It's an uphill battle here from here.
Yeah, great work there by Trident to start this one off as they obviously get set and try to hold out as many points as they can as we'll head into the next one in 14 seconds. But right now, you know, we'll find Shocks inside this hard point, getting the scrap time, getting as much as he can for the team, and of course allowing Mindfreak to sort of get some points on that scoreboard. Two-piece coming into Biolab as he heads across over there. Of course, the next one being located there at Eskies or Red, and then they'll hop to stairs to try and get that lead back.
27-23. The score's going to be closing on up, and Denz wants to make it tied game right here. No one's actually going to be in the hard point. They had to come back straight off those respawns. That's how much slay game we have right now.
Oh, look at that kill feed, though. Fighters two-piece. Denz picks up one. Buzzin picks up another. You know, it's no wonder they brought this back and now got the lead in their favour. So Mindfreak looking very strong as per the norm for this squad and for them in this series. Right now, you'll see a few players dropping from both teams, but you know, not only is Denny out in that sort of situation, the Hill will stay in charge with Mindfreak their control. And right now, it's going to have to be trying to try and make a break here in these final 20 seconds before it heads around to blue.
Yeah, and I mean, with that, we are going to be seeing the Trident team just getting slaughtered from that previous hardpoint. That's going to allow them to get the good spawns there, set up over on this next hardpoint. And I mean, early in the day, we saw Trident play, and we saw them play on this map against another team, and they were able to get that blue hardpoint locked down. No one was able to get in, and I think with that, if they can do the exact same for this time around, they'll be able to make some magic happen. And you are going to be seeing, you know, those players are there, but Mindfreak are now going to contest. Players just barging in, doing what they want. Shock's going to be the last one for a moment, being contested still here. Able to pick off the kill. No one
Beeson just went in there and got a three-piece, and Shock's just like, nah, none of that, mate. See you later. I'll take you down, and I'll keep this hill for our team. So I want to go for a listen in now with this Mindfreak squad. They are up in this in the hard point. They're up in this series. They might know that they've got this one in the bag. It's not definitely secured right now, but I want to see what their comms are like, even though they are up by what they are in the series here. So enjoy the Astro listen in with Mindfreak.
Which dead? Aye. Two in. Go. We should be able to trade back.
Talk.
Good stuff. That's one green. What's your purple?
Purple.
We're gonna try and get your eyes.
One drop, green door.
He's in. Fuck, man.
Probably should have waited a bit because they're gonna push that, so I need help.
Wait, he's one shot.
Two in box.
I got green hot.
Chip's one.
Wait, drop. Yeah, he's tagged.
And that was Mindfreak there. You know, obviously you hear the comms still coming out strong, even though they are up in the series. They're up at the moment in this hard point. I want to see how Trident are going. I want to see if they've still got that, you know, composure that they need right now to stay alive in this hard point. So again, thanks to Astro, and we'll go with Trident.
Another one.
Just break these boys, let's go.
Together, as soon as we get together, push. Like, doesn't matter if you die, push.
I got two.
Nice, there we go.
Good break, Damien.
Dems, one shot.
Got him.
What's snow?
No. Doesn't matter if you die, just bait for each other.
That's it.
Watch my white, I'm watching
you. White, one shot. He's not pushing,
Oh my god. White.
Hold this next. Dude, I can't because.
Another one in purple. Nice.
I did.
But keep baiting for each other. I spawn purple.
Sorry, dude.
Top cat.
Okay, can
we
get it?
I got two.
Come on, man. Last guy in.
Last one. Nice. Big Drake, watch your boxes. Watch your green.
I'm one shot.
Boxes.
Watch it in. Dense.
Oh my god.
I'm pushing again.
I did boxes.
I'm pushing again.
Fighters, watch your boxes. I'm coming green with you.
Fighter, watch your on boxes.
They're buzzing.
Slow weak boxes.
Boxes only help.
And we're back there from that listening from Trident. A little bit different communication compared to the team from Mindfreak.
Yeah, you know, when we first got into that listening, they were a little bit more quiet and less intense than what I was expecting. But then after they got a couple of kills there and that middle biolab hill, you know, really helped them boost it up there. However, Mindfreak did start managed to squeeze away now. 73 and counting points lead to them as they're on currently that second rotation. Hill will rotate now in 10 seconds. Odawar, Red, or Eskies. And of course, that's where they'll try and set up even more of a lead right now. Big kills coming out from both these teams. It's Fighter on our screens. You know, he's trying to keep these guys away and trying to help all his teammates get set up there on the next.
Still 3 minutes 50 though. I mean, if Trident decide to put their, you know, big boy pants on, they might be able to get back into this game. I mean, it is possible, but it's all about being able to get those kills, get that control, and be able to hold it. With Dez just being able to glide on in through a window and then be able to get a couple of kills with Shocks and Buzzing there with him and then just clean out that hard point, it's just not going to happen.
Yeah, from a slaying point of view, looking at that, you know, Damage and Beast and both up there and keeping up with Mindfreak. Chillians and Faith, though, struggling a little bit here. If they picked up a few more kills or, you know, controlled a bit more in that sort of situations, then maybe it would be a much closer game than what we're seeing. 110 to 175. 20 seconds left on the current hill. Shocks just came in. Fight a whole clip. I think it was Damage. Yeah, Damage ended up getting a two-piece in that time as well. So you sort of want to try and connect with the shots in that sort of situation. But you'll see there on the minimap, as well as your COD vision, that Mindfreak are pretty much all given up on this hill. They'll head over to Blue and try and increase their lead once again in that situation.
175 points, though, to 129. Over onto this Blue hard point. Once again, as you mentioned, Mindfreak going to be getting that. Shocks with a double kill, though. He's going to fall shortly after. Dez is just going to be waiting over onto this catwalk, be able to get one, looking at a second, getting tags, but will get taken. Now, Fighter's going to be in the hard point itself, and he's just going to be waiting on the top of these boxes right here as the team of Trident are going to be looking to break through. Now, he's going to have his hands full, but I take that back because his teammate just has everything covered.
He pretty much had the whole team coming in on him from all different angles, but his teammates respawned and really helped him out there because Fighter wasn't too sure where to be looking at due to that sort of situation. You'll see Shocks come in there as well. Picks up a two-piece now. Fighter, who's still inside that half point. Dens is there too. 212 to 129, the scoreline becomes. Trident trying to make a bit of an attack here. Beaston picked up that two-piece that he entered on through, but didn't last much longer than that as he got cleaned up as well. And again, you know, kill feed coming up for MF there with Buzzin's two-piece as well. Look at that scoreline right there, Mike. So almost a 100-point lead to the Mindfreak team.
Not only that, I was expecting this map to, you know, finish to be somewhat close. That's already out of the question. However, this might even end by the score limit itself in 25 more seconds if they're actually able to hold it. Now, they've already got control of this green hardpoint. They're going to be able to pick up those kills. Shox with the double. Now, Fighter and Shox will fall. Buzzer getting to himself as well. And they still got Dent in this hardpoint. 231 to 135 with 90 seconds remaining is just not going to be possible regardless. But, I mean, it's all about hitting that score limit now.
It is for them. You know, they're 15 seconds away and less than that now, as I say. Now down to 10, 30 seconds left on the current hard point. They're just controlling that. Trident do manage to get on through the setup that Mindfreak had. Now FaZe up there collecting some points, and FaZe two-piece helped him out to secure that location. 241 to 143, that scoreline right now, as Mindfreak wanted to close down this current hard point. They can still do that, but they need to take it back over. It's 13 seconds left to be had, 9 seconds, which is what they need, but it won't be happening here. They might have to do it in that next hard point, of course, which will be located inside a bio lab. You can see them there already set up, thanks to CodVision, and again, that mini-map here in broadcaster mode. And in comes Chillians to clean house, picking up two. Beaston picks up one as well, as the rest of them now get set up once again in mid to try and stop MF from closing out at 250.
I mean, they're just trying as hard as they can. Now, 40 seconds still on that clock, and they're going to be contested right here, Mindfreak. Mindfreak, though, Dent and Fighter picking off kills. Damage and Fader there to make something happen. Shox and Buzzard now in this hard point. Buzzard will fall, Shox will fall, and Trident once again will just be alive here in this hard point. Now, where was this Trident for the rest of the earlier stages of this hard point?
You're exactly right there. You know, this MF team has needed 9 seconds for the last, roughly about, I would say, you know, a good 60 seconds, if not more. And Trident have stopped them and shut them down in that regard. Now, I may have spoken too soon. Mindfreak come in. Oh, they might get shy 1 second before. I think they're going to get short 1 second off this if Shox can keep it uncontested. No, he won't be able to. Again, they push on through. Great effort there by Trident to really realistically, you know, stop MF from closing it out at 250. But, you know, MF, at the end of the day, they still won. It's still a 6-0 in the regards to the total series. And Mindfreak are your Call of Duty Advanced Warfare champions for ACL Brisbane 2015.
Of course, the first national event here from ACL. They made their impact. They made their point that they are still the reigning champions from APAC. From, you know, the international performance there at COD Champs, yep. Then to Gfinity, they had a little bit of a downpour, come back here, up and a high, not defeated at all.
Yeah, obviously they'll be feeling very happy with that. Buzzin, I know, will probably take that win to the casino tonight and perhaps lose it all unless he follows me with their betting regime. But Shox hitting the 40 bomb there as well to finish things off. All the rest of his team up in over the 30 side of things as well. But, you know, Shox had a phenomenal game. 10 captures, 3 defense to his name. Yep. KD of 40 and 28, so 1.43. You know, it's going to be interesting to see the overall stats from this event. Again, you know, does play stats have been performing that all weekend long. So a shout out to them. And now, of course, the official sponsors here, Astro Gaming, Ben Q and HyperX, who all made this possible here for ACL Brisbane 2015. And again, you know, all the staff, all the volunteers, and obviously all the casters. You know, some new faces here this year. We had some new casters come in.
Yeah,
and
we did.
And, you know, get their first land under their belts. So hopefully we'll see them more and more at each event coming up in the future. Of course, that was, of course, Benny and Vector.
From the Cast-Off program, I just wanted to point out, it was from the Cast-Off. Of course, that's always open. So if you do want to apply for that, just feel free to hit up at ACL Pro.
A few of you girls need to hit it up, I feel. I would like to get some female casters involved in the scene. You know, a lot of them are like, oh, I'd love to. But then they're like, oh, I can't really talk. You know, but it's an experience. It's a learning curve.
Yeah.
Give it a go.
He couldn't talk when he started either. Neither could I. If it makes you feel better.
Yeah, I couldn't. I still can't talk.
Yeah. I think I'm in the same boat.
I'd give it
a go,
though. Apparently, it works. Apparently, people are like, yeah, that sort of makes sense, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. Some people sometimes just don't even listen.
People keep getting me back, though, yeah. So that's all that matters, I guess, in the end of the day. But, you know, right now, obviously, Mindfreak feeling very pumped, very happy with their performance here. We're going to hand it on over now to Immaniac to give a post-match. Oh, no, we're not yet. The guys are still getting set up and ready. Instead, you know, obviously it was a long weekend, but we saw some great series overall, Mike. So your favourite series, you know, the series, the battle everyone was looking forward to was obviously that Trident and Avant one. I watched that live.
Yeah.
I think it wasn't as intense as we all thought it was going to be, but...
Yeah, I actually casted that one as well, and I do got to admit, I was a little bit disappointed at that. Yeah. It wasn't the grudge match that I was hoping for, but I think the match that really struck me the most was the Incept and Avant game. Over onto that feature station, you know, Incept being able to clutch it out and be able to take out that win as well. And I mean, they performed excellent. I mean, they ended up coming fourth as well for those who missed out. You know, Mindfreak first, Trident second, IG third, Uproar IG third, and then, you know, we had a fourth as Incept.
As I'm getting a lot of thumbs up and I'm trying to nod as much as I can to the production team, we are ready on the floor with a Maniac and the winners of ACL Brisbane for 2015, the team of Plantronics Mindfreak. Over to you.
Guys, I'm here with the champions of the Call of Duty tournament here, Mindfreak from Plantronics. Guys, here in the audience, give them a round of applause. They've just taken out our tournament over the weekend. These guys must be thrilled, and what a tournament it has been. Buzzo, I've had the pleasure of talking to you a few times this weekend. Tell me, I just want your general feeling after taking out our event.
Feel great. No, I don't know. It's amazing. We just come here to win, and we do that. We play our game and come on top. It's basically, we're trying to improve ourselves overall for overseas, basically.
Great. So, look, going along the line, I'm going to talk to all of the Plantronics Mindfreak lineup. Now, Dens, although you've been a staple of the team for quite a while, you're still the freshie on the squad. I just want to know how you're feeling on this squad, and do you still feel that this is Australia's squad for the foreseeable future?
I kind of hate them all. They've all got big flaws. But no, seriously, they're all pretty good. They all lift their weight. There's a couple of things to fix up, but, you know, I definitely think this is the best squad for Australia and to compete overseas.
All right, so moving along to your teammate, Shox. Now, Shox, you've been one of the crazy slayers this weekend. What I'd actually like to know from you is, out of the teams that you competed against, who you think was actually the hardest team for you guys? Was it Trident who you just came up against, or do you think there was someone else who really stood out as a challenge for you?
With the main slayer part, definitely not really true, to be honest. But the best team we versed, probably Swifty's team, which was, what's their name again? Textbook. Yeah, they were pretty good. They took an S&D off us, so I guess they're probably the best opposition.
All right, so moving along to you as well, Fighter. Look, I'm going to ask you the same question. I just want to know your thoughts. Who do you think was your standout from the tournament here? Who's the team that really stood out as a challenge? Maybe not challenge is the right word, but who do you think really stood out from the teams of that we saw this weekend?
I gotta say, it definitely wasn't Barney, my little brother. He can't play on without his 5 upload. But if it had to be anyone, it'd probably be Fate. He played really well, so props to him.
All right, props to those guys. All right, I'm gonna come back to Buzzo, captain of Plantronics Mindfreak. Look, you guys only dropped 2 maps throughout the entire competition. 3? Was it 3?
Forfeit.
That was a forfeit. Okay. All right, so 3 the entire bracket, including a forfeit. We'll call it 2. You guys played amazingly well. You only dropped 1 map in pool play. Look, some final thoughts from you, and then perhaps maybe a shout-out to either sponsors or anyone like you'd like to give a shout-out to at home.
Yeah, of course. Massive shout-out to Plantronics. You know, they make all this possible. Scuff Gaming, we've got newly on board games. And, you know, we've been all coming to ACL Lands for a while now and bringing our monitors every time. It's a pain in the ass, I guess you could say. So being able to bring a portable monitor, basically put your Xbox in it, it's really amazing. Just makes things really easy, I guess. You know, you can bring it on carry on or whatever. Shout out to you guys, yourself, obviously. I haven't seen someone do, I reckon you're up there. You're up there with the MCing. You're a good guy.
Oh, thank
and,
you,
And all the guys are from ACL, Astro for helping sponsoring the event. And yeah, thanks to Naked for helping us out. Everyone knows who he is. And Derek for being a good guy.
Awesome. So thank you once again, and congratulations, guys. One more time, a round of applause for your winners of the Call of Duty tournament, Plantronics Mindfreak. Of course, this event could not happen without the amazing support of our sponsors. First and foremost, I would like to thank Astro Gaming coming on as our console headset sponsor for 2015 here at ACL Pro. Their amazing headsets and mix amps have been featured on our main stage feature station, the Astro feature station, and completely decking out our Halo area. Next up, we of course have BenQ supplying us with their awesome gaming monitors since 2009. Our longest serving supporters here on the ACL Pro Circuit. The newest sponsor for 2015 is HyperX, who we just gave away one of their awesome social media competitions a little earlier. HyperX, of course, supplying us with SSD and RAM, supporting the PC scene as well as our backstage area, making these streams happen. So, guys and girls at home, this has been ACL Pro Brisbane 2015. On behalf of ACL Pro, all of the staff and people that make this happen, we'd like to thank you all for watching both our Alpha and Bravo streams. Don't forget, up next is going to be ACL Sydney at the end of June. You can get all of the details of that event on our website at aclpro.com.au. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and on our Twitter handle at ACL Pro. For now, that's going to wrap things up. I'm Emaniac, and we'll see you guys next month in Sydney.